today on Special Edition TV. Banking on selling your life insurance for cash? You could be in for a rude awakening.
Some people don't yet know there's a problem.
The New York Times calls them spin life policies. Others describe them as stranger-owned life insurance. And seniors across America have acquired thousands of policies valued at billions of dollars. And to participate, all you needed was health and wealth.
You took out a policy rather than the traditional relationship between an insured, a policy owner, and an insurance company. You added a third party to the program, which was a lender.
And that third party paid the premiums and made loan payments until you sold the policy, which would give you the cash you needed to repay the loan. Miami-based Sheridan Wealth Advisors President Mark Sheridan works closely with major banks, top law firms, accounting firms, and charities by assisting the wealthy with complex tax issues and innovative charitable giving.
Up until 2008, you could sell that policy for the loan amount plus typically 10 to 20% of the value of the policy.
Sounds too good to pass up? Well, there are a few strings attached. In fact, some of those strings are really chains.
Premium finance was viewed as a printing press for free money. That movie ended with the credit crunch. So like there's fewer buyers for real estate, there's fewer buyers for policies.
Most folks don't understand necessarily what they're getting when they get an insurance policy.
Louis Balbriere, partner from accounting firm R.G. Wilston Robinson, headquartered in Virginia, is a leading authority in the field of premium finance.
I think seniors should be nervous, especially if they were involved in this product and don't necessarily understand what they have. It's very difficult to be able to sell, and so now we've got issues both from a business perspective and from a tax perspective on what happens with those loans.
With corporations like Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway spending billions of dollars to buy huge blocks of life insurance policies from investors, plenty of seniors jumped on the money train between 2002 and 2007. While some fortunate seniors were able to cash out while the market was still hot, today's policyholders face a terribly challenging environment.
If you have a policy that's not sellable, then you're responsible for it. And most people never took these policies out with the thought that it would be anything other than a home run moneymaker. And this is going to be unwelcome news as people become aware of the potential problem. When these policies are not sold, there's no question that people are going to lose money. Typically six figures, depending on the size of the policy, could start approaching seven figures.
Additionally, there are those pesky tax code rulings on anticipated profits, which can mean additional complications. Many people also receive cash or gift incentives like a cruise and must pay income tax on the value of those goodies.
It could be very scary, especially if you don't know what you have.
What started as a simple transaction with large profits has now turned into a complicated problem that can be costly for seniors if they don't know how to deal with it. However, there are potential solutions.
Months before the loan matures, they should be in the marketplace trying to solicit offers. Generally, you have to look at mitigating your losses.
At this point, I think the best course of action is to understand exactly what you have and understand what the options are and understand what the tax implications are so that you can start to make some good decisions. The best team that you can put together would be your CPA, a good attorney, somebody specializing in estate and gift, and then somebody on the team that understands insurance.
For Special Edition TV, I'm Richard Allen. Find Sheridan Wealth Advisors at 954-260-9010 or on the net at SheridanAdvisors.com. To reach Special Edition TV, go to SpecialEditionTV.com.